I put this on. You know, can you tell something about your new album, what's coming out in a few weeks?
Well, it's round, and it has a hole in the middle, and it comes in a cardboard cover.
Well, what's happening in the grooves?
In the grooves?
Yeah.
Well, we have a bit of dust here and there. It jumps a lot, but once you put a bit of a weight on the arm, you know, you cut through all that, you know.
Ha ha! Ho ho! Once again, I bug you, but really, it's...
Pardon me, but ho ho ho!
I'm sorry, but it's, you know...
Actually, I'm bloody pissed.
Yeah. Why, how come?
Well, this.
Yeah. You don't like the champagne.
Pardon?
You don't like the champagne.
No, I like beer.
Oh, yeah. Are you still a champagne beer drinker?
Oh, of course, yes. Champagne Charlie is my name.
Oh, yeah. It's a champagne some kind of sidekick for...
Yes,
yeah.
But I can't get the beer.
Oh, yeah.
Jim? Jim? Where are you going? Here's a man who will tell you all about it. Actually, this is our producer, record producer, Richard.
Round, plastic, hole in the middle, and a very nice cover.
What has been delayed? What's the reason that it comes later than it was supposed to? What has been the reasons why it comes out of March?
Well, it's never supposed to arrive until it's finished, completed, and perfect. And then it arrives.
Where is it recorded?
Oh, well.
Okay, I've been asking about the new album, and everyone has been told that...
I told them the shape.
It's around, and you know, there's a hole in the middle. Can you tell something more about...
Well, it's difficult to come up with any sort of direct definition of what it's like, because in so much that the second LP differs from the third LP differs from the fourth, you find that this one differs from all of them. We are improving musically, I think, and it just shows in the LP that there's a marked improvement in the sort of technical ability of what we're doing. It's one number that involves a mellotron, which John Paul Jones plays, and that's a very nice number, very sort of mellow number. It's probably one of the mellowest numbers we've done, and it's the mellotron. Obviously, you know about the mellotron, do you? It sounds like an orchestra, yeah. So we're still playing all the instruments ourselves. Apart from that, there's synthesizer on another track and usual sort of array of guitars. It's quite an interesting LP, though. It's got lots of different aspects to it. You know, harder rock and then the mellow numbers. It's quite interesting.
Both had some mellow numbers too.
Yes.
Yeah,
and the first.
Same kind of lineup.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. Yeah. What have you been done with a few last year?
What?
What have you been done? How do you have spent much time on the road?
Well, we have, but you haven't heard about it. We were in Japan, Australia, New Zealand, America, and we did some time in England as well. You know, we've been working very hard, actually. We never stop recording all these things. It takes a lot of time.
It takes quite a lot of time. It's taken quite a lot of time, this new album.
Huh?
It has been taking quite a lot of time, this new album.
Yes, it was finished before Christmas. But Atlantic Records, and well, not Atlantic, but more so the printers that they employ, subcontract printers. It's taken them so long to get the artwork correct, the colours, and even now they're not correct. But still, to get it out, we've just got to settle on a compromise.
Yeah. What kind of cover it has?
Well, it has a photograph, which is hand-coloured, And there are so many colours in the original artwork that they just didn't seem to have the facilities to be able to cope with the colour processing. There's a lot of children on the cover, and there's a sunrise.
What kind of lyrics there? Are they happy lyrics? What kind of lyrics do the songs have?
The lyrics, there's some very thoughtful lyrics. All the lyrics are printed on the LP as well. They're all involved, so you can read the lyrics for yourself when the LP comes out.
Are they more important the lyrics than the earlier requests you have printed?
Are they very strong lenses?
Not really, no. It's not just a case of them being more important. It's just the fact that we've never done that before.
My name's Wicker.
Apart from this track, we wrote the lyrics down on this. How do you do? Wicker's World. And we thought it would be nice as a change to write down the lyrics. I doubt if we'll do it again. It's just one of those things, you know, you do all manner of things during cover production.
How is now your sound? Is that, do you still play in your repertoire when you stage act? Do you still play old numbers from your previous LPs?
Do we still play old numbers? Yes.
Do you have very much unrecorded material on your stage act? New numbers which you haven't recorded yet?
We've got enough for maybe two and a half LPs of unrecorded material, but we don't usually do it on stage.
Do you have any plans to do some live LP?
Huh?
Do you have any plans to do a live LP on the stage, live LP?
So say that again, I couldn't hear.
Do you have any plans to do a live LP, live LP?
A live LP? Not really, no. Not a whole LP. We might employ some one or two live tracks in a future LP, but nothing certain as far as that's concerned. I don't think we'd do a full live LP. I mean, we may do in another year or so, but there's no plans.
How is now if you have to put your own verse for your sound now, what's the difference between your sound 2 years ago and now?
Well, it's more mature. We're maturing all the time. We also use a lot of unusual time signatures, like Black Dog, things like that. There's strange timing involved in certain sections. It's the sort of thing that we didn't do so much then. A little bit we did, but not to the degree that we now use. The fourth LP and the last LP have got quite a few of those sort of things on. And certainly a lot of the unreleased material is these strange time units, but sometimes they're a bit too involved for the public. You know, they might not really enjoy listening to it. It might sound too strange to the ear.
Has the public coped with your new... when your material has got more complicated with your time, has the public been...
Well, they seem to, because we've been most uncompromising. We've never really... just done something because we know the public will like it. We've always done it because we've enjoyed doing it, and then afterwards hope that they accept it. If they didn't accept it, it wouldn't make any difference. We'd still carry on doing what we felt was right musically, and that's all.
How like the audiences now? You have been playing quite a lot in Japan, Australia. Are there different audiences there?
Yeah, obviously they're very different, and in Japan more so, because there's a language barrier,
yeah,
as there is here. Although you find more people speak English in the Scandinavian Scandinavia, yeah, than than in Japan. You know, you find a huge, great language gap there. But even still, they just listen, therefore, to the music, and the voice becomes another instrument to them. So obviously, they have to listen to it like that, I suppose. But the reactions were extremely fine, very, very good.
Do you have time to do some sessions for other people, or are you...
Not really. I don't have very much free time at all now. Now, if I hand you over to Mr. Cole here, who's ours...
we have to leave.
He's our executive Pont, so if you have a quick chat with him, there he is.
Name some of your own favourites or favourite tracks.
My own favourite tracks? Yeah. Babe, I'm Gonna Leave You. Dazed and Confused. Thank You. Heartbreaker. Since I've Been Loving You, Gallows Pole, Stairway to Heaven, Rock and Roll,
okay.
There's a few, yeah.
Okay, thank you very much.